Welcome back to Reading Bear. Today, we will take a look at some new I Don't Work Here Lady stories. And if you enjoyed my content, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and post some bear emojis in the comments. Let's go!
The first story is titled Thank You for the New Phone and a Limp. A while ago, while I was in my break from the retail store that I work at, I was shopping in the electronics store directly next to the store I work at. I was wearing the store uniform, which is a very distinctive red and khaki with a jacket on top, as well as my name tag, which very clearly states what store I work at. Anyways, enter crazy mum and her four kids. I hear this piercing whistle from behind me a few times, so I looked over my shoulder because crap damn it was loud. And this lady is barreling towards me with her kids in tow. As I turned to her to see what all the hustle and whistling was about, she grabbed my wrist and knocked my phone out of my hand. I then look down and can see glass shards everywhere as the phone is smashed to hell. So I give her the classic, "What the duck, lady," to which she responded by hysterically screaming that employees should not be texting while working and that I should be ashamed of keeping her waiting because I was texting. I then turned away and she kicked my ankle as I walked away. I tripped, sprained my ankle, face planted and nailed my shoulder on the shelving. Her kids started laughing and pointing. About this point was when an employee arrived and was able to help me up and see if I was okay. Now she finally thinks for a second and a whole new look came over her face as she realized that I don't work at this store in the first place. Then another new look as I told the employee to call the police. She started pleading with me that it was just a mistake and that she was just having a bad day. Long story short, she was arrested on assault charges and eventually had to first replace my phone, second was given 350 hours community service, third I was awarded a decent sum of money, and my personal favorite is that she has to pay for and attend therapy sessions for the next 3 years. On account of her rage issues. The next story is titled, So You Can Shop But I Can't. A few years back I was a store manager for a denim brand in a big mall. One day somebody drove into a power pole or something, and one half of the mall's power went out. Luckily for my team and I, we were on the now dark side. Power outages are generally loved in retail because you have to have all customers leave to store due to safety. Then if you're lucky, it's too dark to accomplish any work. So you sit. And wait. And get paid. At least until an impatient customer comes along and expects the circumstances and their rules to be different for them. It'll just be us, says the 40-something father next to his clearly embarrassed 15-ish-year-old son. We'll be really quick, we only want to try on a couple pairs. Bottom line and easiest excuses include, it's against policy, and or, I can't put your safety at risk. I was feeling frisky and went with, sir, even if you could see what you were doing in here, I don't have the ability to ring up your purchase. So unfortunately, no. He was annoyed, but they walked away. I had been looking into getting a new phone at the time, and like every mall, there was a cell phone kiosk right outside my store. It was daytime, so the skylights allowed me to still see my options. While talking with the cell phone guys, I get a text from a coworker inside the store. It just said, "Turn around." Standing at my store again is the man and his, "I don't want to be here, son." And the way the man looked at me can only be described as the best resting idiot face a man in cargo shorts can accomplish. After a few more minutes I head back to my store where the man says to me, "So you get to shop but I don't." Retail employees rarely get their way, so I decided to truly enjoy this moment. With the biggest, happiest of customer service smiles I responded, "Sir, you are absolutely right. Enjoy your day." He later returned to inform me that he'd bought our products at Macy's and gotten them 30% off. Oh, and that I should be ashamed of myself. To which I replied once again with the biggest of smiles, "Macy's carries our outlet line, which are 40% off online currently. I hope you enjoy our products." Sometimes the customer isn't right, and it feels so good. The next story is titled, "No words were needed, I have been paranoid about being mistaken for an employee since I started reading r/I Don't Work Here Lady. Even had nightmares about it. I'm usually pretty careful, but last month I slipped up. It was mid-December, so the Christmas shopping frenzy was in full swing. I had already done mine on Cyber Monday, but that particular morning I had fed my cat the last crumbs at the bottom of the bag and really needed to stop after work to get cat food among other absolute essentials. I stopped at the local blue vest place because it was my only chance to grab everything I needed in one stop. As soon as I stepped through the doors, I felt eyes on me. Intensely. Then it dawned on me, I had worn my blue company polo today. Same shade and everything, save for a print of the healthcare company I work for on the right breast pocket. I resolved to get in, at least get the cat food, no kitty of mine goes hungry, stay low-key, and get out. I stayed out of the main aisles. I didn't make eye contact with anyone. If somebody started approaching me, I quickly ducked around a corner. I was killing it. I had everything but the cat food when I finally ran into the boss of this level. There were several people in the cat food aisle, including an older man. He was visibly confused and upset, and was shuffling through cat food bags. They quite obviously didn't have his brand on display. I approached slowly and quietly, like a lioness stalking prey through the tall grass of the savannah. I reached around the man and grabbed the kitty kibble. I thought I was home free, but when I dropped the bag in my hand basket, the old guy finally noticed me. He locked eyes with me. He took a breath and was preparing to say something probably along the lines of, "Hey, could you check the back for blah blah brand?" If he asked me for help, other customers would hear, and at that point it might as well be sharks drawn to blood in the water. I took a gamble. Before a sound escaped him, I quickly put my finger to my lips indicating for him to shush. The gambit paid off. Rather than get incensed at the audacity of the gesture to a customer, he was confused and curious. I shook my head and pointed to the logo on my shirt. He peered down through his bifocals, said a simple HM. Okay. And he went on his way. No real words exchanged. I hauled it through the back aisles to the cash registers, paid, and got the heck out of there without any more unnecessary human contact. The next story is titled, "I Hate Clappers, This Just Happened Today." I'm at my local Wally World, Walmart, dressed in my Hawaiian shirt, shorts, and just not looking anything like an employee of Walmart. I am with my cart, grabbing chips and salsa for a gathering I have this evening. A nice gal of about 5'0" asked me to help her get some chips from the upper shelf. Why is it the shelves for the chips are always empty at this Walmart? I, being 6'6", get asked often to grab things from the high shelves. I feel for you vertically challenged folks. So I grab the chips and pass them to her. She thanks me and goes on her way. Then it happens. The huff. I turn and see her, she says, "Now that you're done flirting, where can I find the batteries?" I chuckle and say, "Well, what kind?" She cuts me off and starts clapping where? Clap, a clap, the. Clap batteries. Clap. I then say, "I'm sorry, you don't need to clap, I don't work here." She cuts me off again and says, "Don't have me get your manager. Where, clap, clap, the, clap batteries." Now I knew what she was asking, but being that I hate clappers, it's the rudest form of communication possible. I say, "They are over in the automotive section. Just talk to one of the service techs out there." She storms off. I continue my shopping when about 5 minutes later, I hear the scream. "That's not what I wanted. Where is that at $H, Le Associate?" I start grinning, here it comes. She hunts me down and says, "They only have car batteries there. I wanted small batteries for electronics." I look at her, I smile, and then say, "You. Clap were clap, not clap specific. Clap." Her mouth drops open, she gasps like I just stole all the oxygen from the area. She then says, "Where is your manager?" Now I work remotely for my company, my manager works in a different state. I say to her, "Likely in St. Louis. As I tried to tell you, lady, I clap don't clap work clap here." I then turn and walk away, while she spews hate and vulgarity in my direction. I am calling it a good day. Don't clap at me. I'm not performing for you. Edit, damn guys, thanks for all the upvotes. So sorry about the editing. I was in a rush to post it so I could get my evening going with friends. I wanted to get it on here while it was still fresh. I also want to clarify a point. The first lady who asked for the chips, she is not the clapper. I was happy to get her the chip. She was also adorable as hell, so yeah, we may have been flirting a bit. The next story is titled, "Sorry ma'am, flight attendants aren't actually airport employees." A few days ago I was between flights in the RSW airport, grabbing a cup of coffee. I'm in my flight attendant uniform and I get approached every once in a while, and I do my best to be polite and help people out since most airport questions are easily answerable. A woman approached me and asked where the smoking area is. I'm not a smoker and I've only been to this airport a few times, so I'm not actually sure. Me, a smoking area? I think I saw one over by the Dunkin' Donuts. I'm not sure if there's one on this side. Lady, way over there? That's the other side of the airport. Are you sure there's not one over here? Mind you, this is fairly small airport. It takes about 5 minutes to get across the entire terminal. Me, I'm sorry ma'am, I've only been here a few times, actually. I work out of Minneapolis, so this airport is pretty foreign to me, hehe. Maybe you should ask one of the gate agents or someone working at the coffee shop? I try a charming laugh. Lady, but I'm asking you now. Why can't you be helpful here? She's getting frustrated with me. Me, again, I don't actually work here. Us flight attendants don't actually spend a ton of time at the airports we go to. I don't know the layout. My coffee arrives and I ask the barista about smoking areas. Barista, there's a smoking area just over there. You can actually see it from where you're standing, ma'am. It's literally 50 feet away. I hadn't noticed it since I don't smoke. Things like this usually aren't on my radar. Me, oh, it's right there. Nice. Just for future reference, ma'am, flight attendants aren't actually airport employees, so we're kind of helpless with things like this. Haha. Have a great day, all right? I'm trying to be charming. Lady, HMPH. Then why did you try to send me all the way to the other side of the ducking planet if it's right there? Whatever. Learn how to do your job, ahole. She walks to the smoking area in a huff. The barista and I looked at each other in silence for a few seconds before sharing a quick laugh. I swear, I did my best to be helpful even though I didn't actually work there. Even after explaining this, the woman insisted that I worked at the airport. The next story is titled, The Best R/I Don't Work Here Lady. I was at the Hot Topic at my hometown mall, cringy, I know, looking for a new pop figure I need to complete my collection. Since the one I needs was a Hot Topic exclusive, I saw one of the employees struggling to restock, so I decided to help him out. It was heavy stuff to lift upon the shelves, to be quite honest. Moments after, a lady about the same age as me walked up to me and showed me a picture on her phone. She seemed frustrated. The photo was of an item that they sell exclusively at Hot Topic, the same exact pop figure I was looking for. She then proceeded to ask me, "Can you check in the back to see if you have this in stock, please?" She was pretty polite, so I responded, "Oh, I'm sorry, I don't work here, but I would love to help you find it." She became furious, which I can understand. She then screamed, "I just saw you stock the shelves. Are you really that lazy that you have to tell me you don't work here?" She then storms off. I became concerned considering it was a misunderstanding and nothing more, plus, she was already frustrated about the pop figure. I began to look for her so I could help her out. I found her speaking to the manager of Hot Topic. That's the guy the first mentioned, "I want this pop figure," but he refused to check for me. I walked towards them and the manager said, "I'm sorry, but he really doesn't work here." She then looked at me, annoyed but also embarrassed. Then stormed out. I walked up to the manager and inquired about the pop figure. He had 3 in stock, I purchased 2 of them. I walked out of the store, bag in hand, and walked towards the pretzel cart to get a bite to eat. I sat there for about 15 minutes, then walked towards GameStop. I wanted a new game, but that's not why I went there. As soon as I walked in, I saw the girl browsing the Pokemon section. I walked behind her and pulled out one of the pop figures, then basically displayed it in front of her face while I was behind her. She quickly turned around and saw me. Her face went from bland to totally embarrassed. I told her to take it. She began frantically apologizing while I assured her it was no big deal either way. I then invited her to a drink, which she agreed to. Her name is Allison. We've been together for 2 years now. The next story is titled, Lost Job 2 weeks ago. An old boss keeps texting me insisting I do work. At first I responded politely explaining I can't help anymore because I don't have access to relevant systems and also am not an employee, have a new job and am busy. I then cut conversation short as boss was a nightmare to work for when I was there and didn't want to get into it with them. Boss then responds a day later insisting I call them to help with another, different, issue that I know they don't need my help with as it's such a simple and self-explanatory task. I was laid off BC my role no longer required, apparently, and I left a great handover log and was super thorough in handing everything over, gave boss plenty of opportunity to fact find from me. I was on notice since last October, so there's no way they need my help except from forgetfulness, laziness on their part. Not only that, I got utterly shafted with severance pay and despite being in a great position to help me, this boss wouldn't lift a finger to make my situation better. I literally don't work here, lady, stop texting me. The next story is titled, Look Sir, I do work here, and I am the boss. I am not sure if this belongs here, but I have a story that is the exact opposite of, I don't work here lady, that I felt would be too fun to share. About 5 years ago, I worked at the International Center of a University in the US to give some background info. I am an Asian female, 5 feet 1 inch in height, and though I was in my early 30s at the time, I did still look quite young and was often mistaken for being in my early 20s or late teens. My main job responsibility at the time was the recruitment, training, and management of about a dozen international student interns who worked the front desk. Anyways, we had been swamped that am, so I hadn't had time to go out to eat lunch. I got a sandwich at our campus vending machine and sat down in the break room. The break room was always cold due to the AC blasting through the room, so I put on a comfy university jacket I kept at my desk just to wear during break. I kept the break room door open to keep an ear out for the front, and let my interns know they could still pop in to ask any questions they want. I had hired a couple new students that month, and they were still learning. A few minutes later, I heard a man's voice yell something along the lines of, "No. No. You do not understand. You are stupid. Stupid." The childish outcries exclaimed in a grown male voice made me I immediately stand up and rush to the front desk area, without even remembering to take my jacket off. The man was literally wagging his finger at my intern and yelling while almost comically stomping his feet. I interjected his tantrum and introduced myself as the intern's supervisor, gave my name and position, and told him I could assist him with the issue. The man immediately looked me up and down, scoffed a short no. He then turned right back to the intern and asked her to call the supervisor, as he needed to ask someone who actually works here, not just some young girl like the intern who sits there at the front repeating nonsense. It wasn't my FLRST rodeo with unnecessarily angry students, so I calmly gestured at my intern to step away and planted myself directly in front of him. That made him change his rant towards me, saying, "Listen, I know you Chinese want to help each other, but my issue is urgent and so I need to see your supervisor." Super VI saw. Carl makes dialing phone gesture here, him and he can sign my I-20. Yes, both my intern and I were Asian. But nope, neither of us were Chinese. And I hate when people over-enunciate when speaking to me, my thoughts often immediately go to, English is my first language, moron, as is evident by the fact that I just spoke it to you. Also, it pissed me off that he assumed the supervisor would be male. I did my best to remain calm however, and confirmed the issue. Oh, so you are here to get an I-20 travel signature? If you go online and submit the form, you will. No. God damn it. You don't understand. He screamed. He then proceeded in a rapid rant, saying that I must get a real staff member who actually works there, instead of giving him the same instructions again, because he needed his sign now, because he wanted to go out of town tonight and surely the school didn't want to make him, a student who pays such high tuition, to have to come back on campus just to get a signature before he leaves the country after his road trip? Do I know how money he gives to the school? He asked. Do little girls from China even understand how expensive his luxury trip was to book? He wondered. Get the man who can actually help him in here, he demanded. More background info, university students in the US on an I-20 visa need an updated signature on their form every once in a while in order to travel abroad and get back. Now, I hated it when entitled students asked for expedited services just for convenience. Many students actually planned ahead and made their requests on time, and it wasn't fair to expedite the process for whoever asked the loudest. I was actually the one who had the power to approve very limited last-minute travel signature requests due to real emergency situations such as family emergency, etc., but obviously this guy and his luxury vacation wasn't going to qualify for expedited service just for being a D-bag. I raised my hand and put my palm out in front of his face for a second to stop his rapid ongoing rant. Again, sir, I am the supervisor in this area. No, let me continue. And I hear your issue. My intern here has given you the instructions for I-20 signatures already, but you want expedited service simply because you don't want to have to come back to our office another day to pick it up. Yes? Okay then, no, let me continue. Unfortunately, that cannot be arranged, so please go home and submit the online form like all of our F1 students and wait 2 to 3 business days for a response. He started to speak again, but I put my hand out again to stop him, maintained eye contact, and picked up the phone. Also, sir, if you do not leave immediately, I will be calling campus security to escort you out of this building for harassing me and my staff members. But before you go, just so you know, I will be noting in your form that you are missing XX days from school. Note that you must maintain your full-time student status for your visa. As you have kindly told us of your planned weeks of absence, please be ready to submit documentation of why this was an excused absence from your classes. Lastly, do not insult my staff again or you will be banned from entering this office again. He stood there stunned for a few seconds, then started to say something again, but I then proceeded to dial the number on the phone. I couldn't remember campus security extension, so I was actually pressing random numbers, and so he ran out. This may not have been the best solution ever to a yucky situation, but this was actually the first time I kicked a student out of the office, so I was a bit shaken up about it. The best part of the story though, is what happened next. My boss at the time, white female in her 40s, walked in a few minutes after, and asked me to come talk to her. I thought I was in trouble for some reason. But she actually asked me instead if everything was okay, because she met a rude international student outside. Apparently, the rude man had run into my boss outside, and he had asked her if she happens to know who is the boss of the girl in there, and if she knew how he could talk to him. My boss had said that she was the supervisor of the woman who works in there and asked if she could help. The man apparently then said something along the lines of how she then needed to find him the man highest up the chain, because his issue demanded real work. He was rude enough that my boss actually did call campus police to escort him out of campus property. She told me that next time, the moment he raises his voice, I do not need to even engage him in conversation but can just kick him out immediately, as he was forewarned that is what will happen next time. If you enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel and post some bear emojis in the comments.